Hi everyone, I'm Autumn and I blog at itsalwaysautumn.com. Today I am going to show you how to replace the background in your photo. So you can actually get rid of a boring or distracting background like this one and add in a much prettier background like these fall leaves. This video is sponsored by Adobe. So you'll begin by opening your photo in Adobe Photoshop Elements 2018. And then up at the top, you'll want to click Guided to enter the guided mode. And this will show us all of the different guided edits that are available. The Replace Background edit is listed under Special Edits. And it's right here, and we can just click on that to start the process. As with all of the guided edits in Photoshop Elements, over on the right-hand side, you'll see each of the steps that you need to do to complete this edit. The first step here is just to select out our subject. There's a couple different tools you can use, and I'm just going to use this auto selection tool. All I need to do is click and drag to draw a rectangle around my subject. And when I let go, Photoshop Elements is going to figure out where my subject is and make a selection around it for me, which you can see. This is the selection lines. So it's done a pretty good job of selecting all around my subject. There are a couple of places where it's gotten too much stuff, like right over here, where some of the shopping cart is in the selection. So what I can do next is click on this Refine button. The Refine button helps me see where my selection needs to be fixed a little bit. We can click on this Push tool here. And if I start in the red part or outside my selection and click and drag, it'll take away some of these areas, kind of erase them from the selection, like the shopping cart that I don't want to be selected. And then there's another little piece right there that I'll clean up. And then I see that there's part of his hood that should be selected that's not. So I just start inside my selection and click and drag, and that's going to add those areas back into the selection for me. Okay, I don't need things to be exact right now, but this is just a nice way to take care of if there are any big spots that didn't get selected that should have been. So now I can go to the next step, which is to choose a new background. I have a couple of options here. I can choose a color that I want for the background, or I can click none and it'll take the background out completely. Or I can pick this presets and choose from a couple different photos or other sorts of backgrounds. Or I can import my own photo, which is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna import a photo I have of some fall leaves. Okay, so that's looking really nice already. The next thing I can do for step three is to click and grab my Move tool. And this allows me to move the subject around in the photo or to make the subject larger or smaller. I think this one's going to look a little more realistic if this boy's a little bit smaller in the photo. And then as a fourth step, we can refine the edges just a little bit more. I'm going to zoom in a bit here, and you can see that right here at the top of his hood, there's some part that needs to come out. And so I'm going to click subtract, and then just kind of gently move over this with a brush, and it's going to take those extra portions away for me. If it seems like there's a place that I'm missing, like I think over here on the left, I might be missing a little bit of his hood, I can click over to the Add brush and click and drag there to add the edge of his hood back in. So you can spend a couple of minutes working on this, adding and subtracting and going all the way around the edges if you would like, depending on how picky you want to be with how the edges look. Once you zoom back out, things may look great and you may not need to fine-tune anymore. The final step is optional down here for number 5. You can click this to auto-match the color tone of your subject to the background, and you can play around with that and see how it looks with your particular photo. Okay, then down at the bottom we click next, and we can save it, share it, or continue editing in quick or in expert mode. Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to check my site, itsalwaysautumn.com, for lots more Photoshop Elements tutorials. See you later.